So yesterday I left you in Paithagra, where we heard the divine pastimes of Radha and Krishna, and I hope you had a good night's sleep. And today morning we are starting from Paithagra. Before we do that, let's offer our prayers. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminati Namine. नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे श्री ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा की ऑनलाइन ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा की
जय
ओके बहुत फेंट समबडी सेड जय वन पर्सन आई हर्ड श्रेय वाज इट यू वाज इट नवीन जगन्नाथ चंद्रबाबा थे ना ओके ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा की
जय
ओके सम पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी स्लेप्ट बिफोर इवन वी बिगिन आवर जर्नी एनीवे जस्ट टू गिव यू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम वृंदावन हियर लुक एट माय कर्सर वी वेंट टू अक्रूर घाट वी वेंट टू मथुरा एंड फ्रॉम मथुरा वी वेंट टू मधुवन एंड फ्रॉम मधुवन टू तालवन एंड फ्रॉम तालवन वी वेंट टू बहुलावन And from Bahulavan, we went to Pait here. And from Paithagram, usually Govardhan happens. But we are keeping Govardhan for day after tomorrow. Tomorrow there is going to be Radhakund, which is again another great exalted place. But that we will discuss tomorrow. Day after tomorrow is Govardhan, and following to that is actual Govardhan Puja. So that will be a build-up for Govardhan Puja on Friday. Today, actually, we are here in this place called Gantholi. It's a very small place, but a very powerful place. And actually, there in Braja, there is no place which is inconsequential or which is of no significance or anything like that. So it's a very important place. So let's hear what happened in Gantholi. Okay, before we do that, I want you to meditate on this beautiful deity of Nithai Gauranga. Nithai Gauranga Bhagavan ki. So the pastime is very much related to what you are meditating. There is a verse in Bhagavatam which says, This is a verse in Bhagavatam, very beautiful verse. I think it's in the third canto, somewhere 25th or 28th chapter. So the verse is Hasam Harer Avanata Khilaloka Tibra Sokasra Sagara Vishoshanam Atyudaram Sammohanaya Rachitam Nijamaya Yasya Bhrumandalam Munikrate Makarad Bhajasya. Actually, this verse is so powerful. One of the greatest contribution of Srila Prabhupada, of course, the philosophy, the books, and he has revealed so many things. One thing which he has given us, which we can always resort to, which is accessible to us, is the Lord in the form of his deities. Right? So the deities are not different from the Lord himself. So here is a verse from Bhagavatam, and the verse is telling, Hasam Harer, the smile of Lord's face. Actually, if you see any deity form, doesn't matter which deity, actually we need to develop a relationship with the deities. So this verse is telling Hasam Harer. If you come and just look at the smiling face of the deity or the smiling face of Krishna, Hasam Harer, what will happen? In life, there will be times which are like the dark moments where you want some place where you can go and nobody is seeing you. You want to be alone. You want to cry. You want to have some help and you don't know whom to ask for. This verse is telling, Hasam Harer Avanata Kilalokatibrasoka Srusagara Vishoshanam. So, and Ati Udaram. Actually, the smile of the face is very compassionate. Ati Udaram. And when somebody sees that, Avanata Akhila Loka Tibra Soka Shusagara Vishoshana. People like us who are Avanata, who are immersed in what? Akhila Loka Tibra Soka. In deep lamentation. Because this material world is Dukkhalayam. And there is Tritap. There are these threefold miseries which are inflicted on us. Avanata Akhila Loka Tibra Soka. So much lamentation, so much of regrets. So many things don't go the way we plan. And then what happens? Ashru Sagara. Then a person cries. Ashru Sagara, not just one, two drops. Ashru Sagara. An ocean of tears. So ocean of tears is coming because we are Avanata Akhila Loka Tibra Soka. Because we are having so much of lamentation. Avanata Akhila Loka Tibra Soka Ashru Sagara Vishoshanam. Just by standing before the deities, just by meditating on the smile of the deities, Vishoshanam, it dries up. Hasam Hare Ravanata Kilalopatibra Sokasra Sagara Vishoshanam Atiudaram. Then, Sammohanaya Rachitam Nijamaya Yasya Bhrumandalam Munikrate Makaratnajasya. This verse is telling also meditate on the eyebrows of the Lord. Sammohanaya rachitam nijamaya yasya bhrumandalam munikrate makaradvajasya. The eyebrows of the Lord, you may not pay attention, but the eyebrows of the Lord are so expressive. Sammohanaya, it is so attractive. Sammohanaya rachitam nijamaya yasya bhrumandalam munikrate makaradvajasya. What people are attracted in this material world? Attraction for Cupid, attraction for opposite sex. Strong attraction. It's a burning fire. But this verse is telling, Sammohanaya rachitam nijamaya yasya bhrumandalam munikrate makaradvajasya. Just by meditating on the eyebrows of the Lord, one actually can be freed from this attraction for opposite sex. So the smile of the Lord and just the eyebrows of the Lord. A yogi should similarly meditate on the most benevolent smile of Lord Sri Hari, a smile which for all those who bow to him dries away the ocean of tears caused by intense grief. The yogi should also meditate on the Lord's arched eyebrows, which are manifested by his internal potency in order to charm the sex god for the good of the sages. Of course, there are countless verses in Bhagavatam which talks about the glories of having darshan of the Lord. One of my favorite verses, which I love, is Taddarshana Dvasta Samasta Kilvisha Swastha Malanta Karna Bhayan Muni Prabhuddha Bhaktya Pranaya Shulochana Prahrashta Roman Namanadi Purusham. So this verse is actually spoken by Chitraketu Maharaj when he had the darshan of Sankarsana, Lord in the form of Sankarsana. Tad darshana dvasta samasta kilvisha. Darshan of the Lord, dvasta samasta kilvisha, is sinful activities, the contaminations in our heart. Tad darshana dvasta samasta kilvisha. It destroyed all the sinful tendencies in the heart. Swastha malanta, and the antakarana becomes swastha. It became healthy. So the internal health, the internal consciousness became swastha, became free from all contaminations. And prabhuddha bhaktya pranayashu lochan. The state of Chitraketu Maharaj is very high, very exalted. When he is having the darshan of the deities, he is having pranayashu. He is having tears from his eyes. Pranayashu lochanaha prahrashta roman. And his ears are standing on his body, and he's bowing down before the deity. So the translation is, as soon as Maharaj Chitraketu saw the Supreme Lord, he was cleansed of all material contamination and situated in his original Krishna consciousness, being completely purified. He became silent and grave, and because of love for the Lord, tears fell from his eyes and his hair stood on end. With great devotion and love, he offered his respectful obeisances unto the original personality of Godhead. And in the purport, Prabhupada says, the word tat darshan advasta samasta kilvisha is very important in this verse. If one regularly sees the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the temple, one will gradually be disinfected of material desires simply by visiting the temple and seeing the deity. If one regularly sees the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the temple, one will gradually be disinfected of all material desires simply by visiting the temple and seeing the deity. Anyway, that's the power of having darshan of the deities. And today we are in a place called Ghantoli or Ghantoli. It's pronounced very differently, but it is very close to the Govardhan. This is part of Govardhan. So somebody who's doing Govardhan Parikrama will come across this place. What is the significance of this place? We will see that. So actually this place became very prominent, or it got prominence because of one very interesting pastime which happened. First, I'll tell you the pastime which happened, which we can relate to. And then there was one related to Krishna and Radha, of course, is there. So this is the pastime when Krishna Chaitanya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, wanted to go for Parikrama. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went for Parikrama, and Govardhan, of all the places in Braj, is of paramount spiritual significance. So he was doing this Parikrama, and while doing the Parikrama, he had heard that his spiritual master, Madhavendra Puri, used to worship the deity of Gopal, who is situated on top of Govardhan Hill. So since Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in the form of a devotee, he thought, he was hesitant, he was not willing to step onto Govardhan Hill. He didn't want to. So he was reluctant, and even till now, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's followers, no Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they step on Govardhan. So then, but the Gopal, actually this Gopal deity was made by Vajranath, Krishna's great-grandson, right? Established, who had many deities established in Vrindavan. So this deity, of course, this deity is now worshipped as Srinathji in Jaipur. So that deity has been shifted. But that darshan of that deity, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to have, but he had this dilemma inside that how will he step on Govardhan, and he was not doing. So at that time, Gopal, the deity, engineered a plan. So what he did was, this is not the first time it has happened, it has happened earlier also. So he created a plan where, you know, they got to know that the Muslim invaders are going to attack. So somehow some news came and the Muslim people are going to attack. So immediately they made arrangement to bring down the deity from the top. And as soon as the deity came down, that news reached Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard that, you know, the deity has come down and his desire is getting fulfilled, he danced in ecstasy. There were tears from his eyes. And this is the beauty of the deity's reciprocation. The deities do reciprocate. They are more alive than any human beings here. When we stand, when we express our heart in front of the deities, when we share our problems, when we look for solutions, the deities do reciprocate. And this is exactly what happened in the case of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was just dancing in ecstasy, seeing this beautiful form of Srinathji. Srinathji Bhagavan ki, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki. Good. There is one pastime which happened earlier. That's how the place got its name, as Ghantoli or Ghantoli, whatever it is. The name came because this is a place where when Radha and Krishna were immersed in their eternal conjugal pastimes, surrounded by the gopis, what happened, this was the time of Holi, and Lalita Shakhi at that time, she took the corner of Radharani's sari and Krishna's dhoti and tied it. So this tying of the cloth is called knot, or called ghanta, or whatever that means, knot, ghant. Okay, so, but they're saying ghanta, ghantoli. That's how ghantoli it is. So this tying together of a girl's sari and a boy's dhoti is always done at the time of a marriage ceremony, signifying the union of oneness between husband and wife. When the holy festivities came to an end, and it was time for Radha and Krishna to take their bath at Gulal Kund, when they stood up, to their surprise, they found that their clothes were tied together. At that moment, all the gopis suddenly started laughing and clapping their hands in great happiness at seeing the divine couple tied together, as if they had just been married. So this is the pastime which happened much before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. So the point to reflect on this day, of course, you know, we can see how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was so eager to have darshan of that deity worship by Madhavendra Puri. That kind of eagerness is required. That kind of a relationship with the deities are required. Because like we have relationship with people whom we come across in our life, similarly, the deities are as live and as personal as any human being can appear for us too. So to develop a relationship with the deity, to express one's mind in front of the deity, is a very important spiritual aspect in a sadhaka's life. One another thing which we need to learn from this pastime is, which is worth meditating, is that these deities, we have seen countless examples. We have heard about Sakshi Gopal, we have heard about so many other deities who reciprocate with the devotees based on his devotion, his mode of devotion and surrender. People say or think that Krishna should enter in their life. Krishna has entered their life because they were not devotee earlier, now they have transformed, they are doing something. But for the residents of Vrindavan, for the Brajavasis, it is they enter into Krishna's life. That should be the mood. I should enter into that eternal pastimes of Krishna. I should find a place. Doesn't matter what it is. Dasa, dasa, dasa. That's why when we sing this song in the morning for Tulasi, and second line, ए तुम्हारा शरण लो तारा वांछा पूर्ण हो कृपा करी करो तारे वृंदावन वास ए तुम्हारा शरण लो तारा वांछा पूर्ण हो सो द डिजायर गेट्स फुलफिल्ड कृपा करी करो तारे वृंदावन वास मोर ए अभिलाष विलास कुंजे दियो वास नयने हरिव सदा युगल रूप रास मोर ए अभिलाष आई हैव गॉट दिस डिजायर आल्सो टू गेट अ प्लेस इन विलास कुंजे दियो वास नयने हरिव से युगल रूप रास ए निवेदन धर सखीर अनुगत कर सेवा अधिकार दिए करो निज दास यही निवेदन सुनो यही निवेदन धर सखीर अनुगत करो मेक मी क्लोज टू दिस सखीस सेवा गिव मी द प्रिविलेज ऑफ सेवा ऑफ सर्विस एंड मेक मी ए मेड सर्वेंट सेवा अधिकार दिए करो निज दास दीन कृष्ण दास कहे यही जेना मोर हो श्री राधा गोविंद प्रेमे सदा एन बासी. So instead of trying to put Krishna in our life, we should try, or we should aspire to enter into Krishna's pastimes, enter into the pastimes. So that is the pastime of this place. We will stop here, and as I discussed that, you know, tomorrow we are going to Radha Kund. Radha Kund is just an amazing place. Very, very special place, and Rupa Goswami himself glorifies this place. We will see that tomorrow. So join us for the virtual parikrama of Radha Kund tomorrow, and then day after tomorrow it's going to be Govardhan. It's a lot of distance that we have to cover. There are a lot of significant places. We will see that, and then after that we will have the Govardhan puja. So Ghantoli Dham ki, Rajmandal Parikrama ki. Online, I just only heard Naveen saying one faint jai. I want to hear a loud jai. You can unmute your mic and say jai. कंठोली धाम की श्रील प्रभुपाद की चैतन्य महाप्रभु की Right, so we will have Namada Rashtrakana. Stay tuned. Hare Krishna.